अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9, सब्जेक्ट कंप्यूटर। आई एम सरदीशान इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू एंड टुडे इट्स माय लेक्चर नंबर 8। This is your unit 1 and the topic introduction to computer, page 25. I already taught you many questions and I hope, not hope but I believe you learnt it. So the next question is, why do we need to translate source code into machine code? Two things: source code and machine code. I am telling you about these two things. What is a source code? Dear students, we write computer programs in any computer language, high level language. What is a computer program? You already know about that. Computer program means software, written instructions in any computer language to instruct the computer what to do and how to do. All the programs written by us, by human, are called source programs. These programs are written in any high level language. Do you know what is high level language? High level languages are computer programming languages which are English oriented. We can write our computer program in any high level language. This program is called source program. I hope you understand the definition of source program. What is the question? Why do we need to translate source code into machine code? This source program which you write in any computer language is also called source code. Why it is necessary to translate source code into machine code? Listen, I am telling you what is the reason. Students, the reason is that computer is a machine and we are human beings. Big difference between machine and man. Man can understand the language of other men, but machine cannot understand the language of man. Why? Very simple. Computer is a machine and we are human being. So our program which we write in English, that is source code, computer does not understand this program written in English language. So computer breaks this program into machine language, that is binary pattern, and then computer executes that program. I hope you understand what I am telling you. Now look at the board. Why do we need to translate source code into machine code? Answer. Computer is a machine and we are human beings. We do not understand computer's language and computer does not understand our language. You understand what I'm saying? Computer does not understand our language. We do not understand computer's language and computer does not understand our language. The programs written in high level language by us are called source programs, which computer does not understand. But when these source programs are translated into machine code, computer can execute them. So it is necessary to translate source code into machine code. For this purpose, we use language translators as under. Two things. You understand what is source code and what is machine code. And you also understand now why do we need to translate source code into machine code. Okay? Now the thing is this. For this purpose, for the purpose of translating source code into machine code, we need language translators. That's why it's necessary for you to understand this thing. This process is done by language translators. What are language translators? Language translators are software and they are used to translate source code into machine code. Look at the board now. Language translators. And we have three types of language translators: interpreter, compiler, assembler. Look at this thing. Look at this part of the board very carefully. All of you students, look at this. Now, what is interpreter? Interpreter is a language translator. It translates high level language into machine language, line by line, or statement by statement. It does not translate the whole program in one time. No, no, never. So you should remember the definition of interpreter. It translates our high-level language program into machine language, line by line, or only one statement at a time. I'm telling you the detail now. You see, what's happening over here, when you write a computer program in GW basic language, there are statements, understand? For example, on 10 CLS, on 20, for k is equal to 1 to 10, 30, print assembly caps. Understand what I'm saying? These are called statements. So, interpreter translates the source code into machine code, statement by statement, one statement in one time. If there is any syntax error, it stops. It doesn't go forward. And we will have to correct the syntax error and run the program again. Remember this thing, interpreter, you will have to run your source program again and again after removing any syntax error. I hope you understand that. And I will also show you this thing when I will explain program written in GW Basic for you. Then you will understand more and more. But for this time, you should understand what is interpreter. Number two, compiler. Compiler is also a language translator. It translates source code into machine code. The whole program in one time. It doesn't wait. It doesn't do like interpreter, line by line. No, compiler doesn't wait. Compiler translates the whole source code in one time. There is a big difference in between interpreter and compiler. I'm telling the example. You see, the example, let me tell you this thing. Interpreter you use for GW Basic. You see, interpreter, example, GW Basic. All GW Basic programs are translated by interpreter, but compiler, what languages? For example, COBOL, Fortran, that's the compiler. So it's a difference between interpreter and compiler. What is assembler? Assembler is also a language translator, but it translates only assembly language and no other language. So these are the language translators, their types, and their definition. I hope it's easy for you to understand, because I made the diagram and definition written on the board. Next question. What do you mean by pranamika images? Write your answer with examples. What are programming languages? Listen, programming languages are a type of software. Programming languages are those languages in which you can write a program. And you know the definition of a program? A program is a step by step solution of any problem, and we can write computer program in the computer language. These computer languages are called programming languages. Definition: a programming language is a type of software. We can write a computer program in programming language to instruct the computer what to do and how to do, but step by step. Understand the definition of programming languages? Now, types. There are three types of programming languages: machine language, low level assembly language, high level language. And very shortly, let me tell you what is machine language. Machine language is computer's own language, which is called binary language, 0 and 1. No any other thing is involved, no digit, only 0 and 1, that's it. That's binary language. So machine language is computer's own language, which is a binary language. Number two, low level assembly language. What is low level language? Low level languages are those languages which are written in codes. So low level assembly language is written in codes, and these codes are called numenics. These codes are called numenics. Have a look on the board. Machine language, binary language, 0 and 1. Low level assembly language, which is in codes, numenics. Number 3, high level language. High level languages are those languages which are written in simple English. So it's easy from user's point of view, because we know English language, we can write our computer program in English. These are called high level languages. Example: COBOL, Fortran, Pascal, C language, BASIC, and many version of BASIC language, QBASIC, GWBASIC, etc., Java, and many other languages. These are the examples of high level languages. And remember this thing, high level languages are very easy to write program in high level language. Very easy. Low level languages, they are difficult as compared to high level language because they are written in codes. And if you go on machine language, oh my goodness, very difficult. Why? Because all the statements are written in the form of 0 and 1, 0 and 1. Very difficult to write program in machine language. And this is amazing really, that the computer programmers of many years ago, they used to write programs in machine language, because low level language or high level languages were not invented at that time. Really, really amazing. How did they write programs in machine language? Anyway, I told you these all the things to remember. I shall be waiting for your comments. We are very near to finish Unit 1, Introduction to Computer, and inshallah we shall start Unit 2 very soon.